talking about life expectancy and how that will be increasing. Give me some predictions based off of some technologies that you're looking at and working with now, and then maybe a little overview of what you do to stay healthy.
Sure. Well, you know, the most important technologies right now in the transhumanist world, in my opinion, are ones that are extending lifespans. And there's a couple of different drugs coming on the market. I think there was two FDA approved this the last 6 months that are some of the very first, what we consider anti-aging drugs. And so I think those will be big hits. But I think more importantly, like what the technologies I really see as revolutionary deal with bionics and bionic organs. Most people die from organ failure. So we're in the kind of this age where in the next 3 to 5 years, you're hearing this already, there's robotic kidneys, there's robotic pancreas, but really it's heart disease that kills, number one killer in the world, kills about a third of everybody we know. So it's really the robotic heart that becomes, I think, the holy grail of modern medicine and starts to change almost everything that can be out there. Besides the idea that you can control your bionic heart, you know, you can slow it down when you want to sleep, you can speed it up when you want to have crazy sex or do stuff like that or go surfing. But the idea is really, we need to start to look at replacing our organs with something that's better and something that's probably machine-like, but something that might also just be entirely synthetic biological material. But the point of the story is really that we are starting to introduce those things. There are a number of companies, dozens of companies out there that want to bring in these bionic organs. The problem is that the process of getting them approved is so long and laborious, and I completely oppose this laborious process, especially from a libertarian standpoint. But I think that's the things that over the next 10 years, you're going to hear a lot about. When do you electively go in and replace your heart or replace even an eyeball, something that probably will definitely happen within 10 years. We have some people already replacing eyeballs that have you know bad eyesight or whatnot with FDA approved mechanism. But what, you know, to answer the other part of your question outside of bionic organs, which is the one that I really love to promote and say we need more investment into, is I'm at 45, luckily not having to suffer anything major. So I try to run a lot. I work out all the time. I'm still pretty big on swimming at least a few times a week. And I would say, you know, other than that, I just try to eat well. I don't eat too much meat if I can avoid it. I'm not a big meat eater. And I also try to avoid synthetic foods. You know, anything that's organic is definitely better for you, in my opinion, rather than a bunch of drugs being used to create crops. And, you know, sometimes I'll take nootropic pills and sometimes I've even done some stuff like neurofeedback. But, you know, mainly at age 45, I just try to stay healthy by exercising and eating properly.
Meditate?
Say it again?
Do you meditate?
Oh, I'm sorry. Do I meditate? Oh, that's a tough question. So I used to meditate. The problem with the big problem with meditation, and I would like to meditate, is that, wow, I can barely find 5 minutes anymore to do anything. I'm so always behind. And I now have 2 kids and married and all these other businesses and whatnot. So if I was living in a perfect world, I would have more time. And I think I would very seriously meditate. I used to in my 20s, and it was great.
I hear the saying is something to the effect of, if you can't find 5 minutes, you should meditate for 10. But I'm not great at it either, so I can't really talk. So it seems like you're biggest on bionics in terms of life extension. Why that versus something genetic engineering, CRISPR, or potentially even uploading consciousness?
A quick aside for people who aren't familiar with CRISPR. CRISPR is the technology that allows humans, essentially as simply as working with Microsoft Word, to edit genetic sequences. We can find, edit, cut, and replace in a copy-paste type manner. It's really quite terrifying. The genetic code of life. We'll be doing another episode on CRISPR coming later on, but that was just a quick aside. It is one of the greatest technological breakthroughs of our species, in my opinion, as it allows us to take evolution.
Well, so genetic editing in CRISPR-9 would probably be the second and probably very close in terms of what is better than bionics. The problem, though, is with CRISPR is we really haven't, even though we know it's the most important science of the 21st century, and certainly I think more than AI, more than bionic organs, whatnot, we still haven't figured out as a society if we're going to move forward with it radically fast. And we also aren't sure, given how radical it is, that we can like literally grow eyeballs in the back of our head and things like that, whether we can use it to actually reproduce organs. But in the end of the day, I still don't want another Zoltan heart. I want a machine heart that's going to be far superior to my heart. I want an eyeball that has the telephoto vision of, you know, 50 miles versus my normal eyesight and microscopic vision. There's no question that while biology is good and we can make biology better, I think in the end of the day, it's always going to be something machine and ones and zeros connected to the cloud that's going to be the most sophisticated. And so I'm still holding out for the bionic heart rather than growing either through genetic editing or, you know, through organs of pigs, which I have a friend who runs that kind of company and these kinds of things. I mean, these are great ideas, and they're definitely important to pursue, and money should be going into them. But I'm still a big believer that I want actual metal and bionics and internet and DNA, and ones and zeros inside my body, and not just biological reformations, whatever we get from genetic editing.
This has been another in our Fringe FM mini-series, where we take long-form interviews and condense them down to high-impact topics. If you'd like to get the full interview, check out the show notes, or subscribe, go to fringe.fm,
where you'll find tons of audio and video interviews with leaders in the fields of genetics, cryptocurrency, longevity, AI, space, VR, and much, much more. If you enjoyed the show, please leave a quick review in iTunes to help more people discover Fringe FM.